Alright everyone, Buzz Killington here, back to do another Buzzcast. And today I've taken a replay from Game Replays that already has two wubs and is touted by the uploader as Replay of the Week or something like that, with lots of back and forth action. So let's have a look and see if his claims are justified. The game takes place on Tiberium Rift, and starting on the top left as a GDI faction, we have Hazehi Jahannam, better known as Lord Eon, and I'm going to stick with that because it's easier to say. And as the Nod faction here, Black Hand in fact, we have in purple El Noska, better known as I Am Tibbis, so I'm going with Tibbis for him. So Lord Eon in red versus Tibbis in purple. So standard opener on this map is pretty much always the same. Each engineer goes for their spike, nice and simple. The only difference is in the scouting. And Lord Eon has gone for three GDI scouts here, straight down the middle. He doesn't know what he's facing. He picked his faction, but Tibbis went random. And in a second now, he's going to run into his Baals. He's going to get a lot of damage done. Tried to throw a grenade, but for some reason it landed on themselves, which is not ideal. But three GDI scouts are enough to overwhelm a single understrength Cabal. But the other one has been missed completely, so a bit careless by Lord Eon there will allow Tibbis to get a scout off. Splitting his scouts up to maximize his field of vision, he's going to go for this one. Is there a booby trap there? There is. Tibbis has planted a booby trap there. But unfortunately, the scouts are going to die before they get to trigger it, which is a bit of a shame, really. War factory down, and we're going into eco production from the look of it. Yep, two refineries down, harvest is out, Tibbis is now expanding. Foxhole could be dug by Eon if he likes now. And in the meantime, what have we got going on here? Lord Eon is completely stalled out for cash, but it looks like he's got something different planned. Are we going to see, is a power plant here? It is a power plant. Now he's expanding, war factory back online. But he's got three harvesters out compared to one, two, is that three? Four harvesters, in fact, for Tibbis. So Tibbis definitely has an advantage here. He's getting some bombing done here. Wait a minute, what have we got here? Power plant dropped in the middle of nowhere, as is customary for the more experienced players, so I'm not convinced of the usefulness of the strategy. But he is actually expanding to Lord Eon's expansion point rather than going anti-clockwise around the map as he should. But Eon is completely unaware of this at the moment. Continuing to focus down. Well, not a great deal really. I'm not sure, entirely sure what he thinks he's aiming at. Any harvester he can find, really. That's a bit of micro involved there. Not the most efficient use of his time, really. Got five harvesters out here for Lord Eon, and now we're going into predator production. Two preds out so far, which is interesting considering there aren't any bikes out on the map or any flame tanks. So it's as a purely defensive measure, but he now knows he's got scorpions coming out because this foxhole is doing the very useful vision to him. Cabal coming in to have a look-see. Continuing his predator production. But now, what is going on here? Ah, I see. Lord Eon is aware that Tibbis has attempted to steal his expansion very naughtily. And now he's going to put a stop to that with a little bit of base pushing with his predators. War factory down. It looks like we're going to see some scorpion production out. Don't know why the predators are retreating. They should definitely push into that. He has the numbers to make that work for him. Predator's absolutely streaming in now. If Tibbis is smart, he'll be doing flame tank or something behind it, but nope, he's committed to scorpions right now. Predators are pushing in, and against this, the predators are going to get work done, and it's hard to see how he... There we are, infantry production. That's the only thing that can hold against this right now. It looks like Lord Eon will have to fall back. Although it's very back and forth. Now we have one, two, three Guardian Towers down now. Or whatever they're called. Watchtowers, thank you. And Tibbis is making a run for it. He got cheeky, he couldn't hold it. Harvesters are retreating. He may as well pull his troops back, to be honest. They're just dying here. They're just going to die here. Problem for Lord Eon now is that he has his MCV here. He could drop a refinery here. And he needs some sooner or later to move back and get refineries on this field. So it's going to be a bit awkward for him. Oh, well. See, this is continuing to contest this. But all Lord Eon has to do really is focus down the war factory, as he is starting to do now. Any scorpions pushing in get destroyed. He just needs to focus down the war factory. He doesn't. There we go. Tibbs probably could have held down for a little bit longer. Tier 2 down for Lord Eon now. But eco is going to become an issue for him very soon. But not as much as it is for Tibbs. Where is his MCV right now? Where is his MCV? Where has it gone? I don't know what he's done with this MCV. This is embarrassing. Just one second.
Unit under attack.
He still has it.
Complete.
It's lurking
building
around the map somewhere.
Enemy base sighted.
There it is.
Fuel depleted.
That is a strange place for it. Okay, that explains why I can find it. Even that I'm just digging by. Scorpions are trying to push in, but predators are reverse moving into them, which is the best. But it doesn't matter really, because against these predator numbers, this scorpion force is going to be destroyed, and Tibbs knows it. He's making a run for it. Well, well, well. This is risky by Lord Eon. He doesn't have the eco to sustain this, really. He's got a large predator force up there. The scorpions are retreating. No harvesters on this field. No harvesters going for this field. All the harvesters are moving here. Okay, that's better. We have two rare and 6 harvesters on this field now. What he needs to do ideally, this is probably going to be a tech. Let's see if that's what it's going for. Where's this AP ammo? There it is. It's a power plant. He's going to expand backwards now and reclaim this field, which is exactly the right thing to do. Scorps are retreating. What is Tibbs going to do about this? We now have some bike production going on. He's counting on the predators being very much out of position, which they are. They're very much out of position, but I don't think Eon knows about the hammerheads. Tibbs knows about the hammerheads. Tibbs needs to pay attention. He's going to start losing. There we go. Bikes are getting focused down now. Bikes will get focused down fairly easily. Scorpions now have to retreat because they have no defense against the hammerheads. They're trying to get work done. One harvester falls. Refinery could fall. Second harvester goes down. Good work. He should have pulled his harvesters back, really, and left him with nothing to do but die. But no, now he's pulling them back. But a third harvester is going to fall if he focuses it down properly. He's not going to do it. He's thrown away a scorpion force there. He didn't. Wow, in fairness, there wasn't much to do. The predators are now relocating, which was a bad move because the rocket troops are heading up there now and there's nothing there to stop them. I mean, he could drop watchtowers to see it off. He needs eco, he needs a refinery, he needs a watchtower up here as well to get rid of these rocket troops. But the predators are pushing in. They are severely scattered. This is the best move. Tier 2 is down somewhere. The mantis are coming out to deal with the hammerheads, wherever they might be right now. Tibbs has forgotten about his rocket troops. He needs to do something with them. Bikes are cruising like they've got stabilizers on, being driven by a top. There are the hammerheads. They've taken a fair bit of damage. They need to stay well away from that. Ah, there we are. They've remembered what they're doing now. AP ammo watchtowers are dropped. They can start focusing the rockets down. Bikes are here, but no harvesters are. We now have War Factory down. We have a refinery. That'll be a second refinery on the way. Tibbs is showing a lot of offensive action now, which is exactly what you need in this position. Eon doesn't have much eco at the moment, but he needs to put his troops back. They're not getting in that. He needs tanks to dislodge those. Or a butt ton more of infantry, which is in fact what he's going for. Shrine upgrade is on the way. Black Disciples will be coming soon. We have Tier 2 down here, as we see. That's overkill. That's severe overkill. Yeah, all they have to do is cut right around there, come in this side, focus that one down. They could snipe a lot of harvesters just coming in this way, and there's absolutely nothing to stop them. Where are the hammerheads right now? They're over there. He's sold off his airfield, which is unwise. He needs it for the repairs, really. He needs to get his pred tanks repaired as well. Rifleman Sniper Mantis. I assume that Tibbus just wasn't paying attention there, frankly, because there's by no means should they have got been able to get that. It doesn't matter. Substantial man spam out now from the Black Hand player. Cabal Squad and a Black Disciple upgrade. Let's see if Blue Flame's being researched. It's not. Blue Flame is not being researched, but he's aware of this now. He needs hammerheads. He needs anti-infantry. He needs it quickly. He's got two war factories now producing APCs. These hammerheads need repairs. All they're going to achieve is to die. I don't know. I have no idea what the Predators are doing now. The hammerheads need to get pulled back. The hammerheads need to get pulled back. They need to get repaired. And then they could attack while they're distracted. They're just going to die. One. Two. Three. Last hammerhead makes a run for it and somehow survives. But not the best use here of the decoy. Power, it's... Oh, there are a lot of APCs here. I'm not convinced he'll be able to survive this. Tibbus was going to lose a lot of his troops here, I think. Mantis coming in, but there's one hammerhead left. He's probably dead already. APCs are doing good work targeting down rocket troops. Tibbus isn't going to succeed with this. All he can do here is take down as many troops as he possibly can. That's 1, 2, 3 watchtowers down. More APCs streaming in. There's not enough here now. Move around, have to see what's going. The Predators have moved all the way around. But he knows he's going for man spam, so... Ah, here's a harvester caught out. The refineries have been sold off, but this field has been completely drained. Might well be able to get a kill on this harvester. There we go. Wants to ideally focus down these power plants. There we go. As expected, the infantry force has fallen. The Mantis goes down. The APCs are now pushing forward to see what they can do. And the question is, what are the Predator tanks doing? No. They're pushing into infantry. That's insanity. All they're going to do is die. Eon would have been much better off sitting back here, taking out a couple of the power plants, because look at the numbers of base defenses he's got. He's got lots of anti-air. He doesn't need it. The hammerheads have been sold off. Flame tank round the back. Sneaky flame tank. Comes round the back. And there's nothing at all here to stop it. That's the problem. That is going to get a lot of damage done. More APCs coming in. But look at the man spam. Now, this is definitely too much. The APCs need to pull back. They need to pull back quickly. That flame tank continues to survive. It's just ranking up off towers. And somehow it's made it out of there. Is it going to make it? One more shot is all I need. There we go. I think it was actually the rifleman that ranked up off that. Nice work there. But once again, Eon is now the player on the back foot. Producing APC is not necessarily the best strategy. He might need to go air. He might need to go air and kill this infantry. He's still got lots of anti-air. He might well sell that off once he suspects the hammerheads are gone, and that would be a good time to transition back into it. That is a lot of man spam. The next coming engagement is going to be absolutely critical for this. He could sell off this, at least two of these watchtowers. Send harvesters up here. There's a lot of tip there that could be used. Where on earth are all these troops going? Where on earth do they think they're going? I've got no idea. That's another war factory. How many war factories does he want? He's got 3 war factories. He needs to be thinking about his economy at the moment. He's got so much tip he's not making use of. He has more available than Tibbus does. APC is there. We've got a lot of infantry pushing in now. But what is Tibbus doing behind this? Apart from claiming the blue Tiberium. So that will be a definite boost for him. And we are going to see more flame tanks. Sneaky flame tanks coming around here. We'll easily take that out. They could roll around, take this out. Again, there's not much there to stop it. APC is pushing in, but they need to push in as one or not bother. Look at those numbers. There's a hero squad in there somewhere. Well, there was, he's now died. But yeah, he's got the APC numbers. This is enough to take them down. Am I hearing snipers in there? Nope, that's just my imagination. No snipers in there. Flame tank comes in, as I predicted. Down goes that refinery. The infantry's pushing around here, sniping some harvesters. Good work. But a simple crush maneuver from this harvester. There we go. Will be enough to deal with those. Another harvester falls. Nice micro by Eon there. He's, especially as he's focusing elsewhere. And that's it. That's it. The infantry's basically done there. A couple of bikes pushing in, but they're just, well, dying. They're dying off to the APCs, which is the best strategy. More APCs pushing in, but now we have tech. Tip chem plant down. Oh, yeah. Yeah, look at that placement. In fairness, the flame tank can take this down now, so he doesn't need to use it. He's up to 2,000. Flame tank can destroy all of this. No, 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 don't focus the harvesters. Get in there, destroy those buildings. That's it. APCs pushing in. But there's a purifier here. It's just going to kill them all. It's just all going to die. Madness. No, no, kill the war factory. What are you doing? You're not going to... Ah, okay. Do you see? Do you notice it's taking 1,000 years? There you go. All right, then. Flame tank comes in. War factory is going to fall now. Is that going to be enough to get it to rank up? Not quite, but there's a lot of power plants here. There is also enough there to stop it. Maybe he wants to pull back. And that's exactly what he's doing. Smart. APCs are moving back. But by the time they get there, it'll be too late. Purifiers down. But, oh, hello. The refineries are gone. Did he sell those off? Maybe he did. So it's interesting now. What is going to happen? Tibbus, there's a refinery. Tibbus will be okay. Did all his harvesters die? Bloody hell. Very back and forth this game. They were quite right there. So now Eon is retreating. He's lost his refineries here. He has one refinery here, four harvesters on an almost dry field. That's a lie. Five harvesters on an almost dry field. He's got a refinery up here, but nobody's using it. He needs a refinery here. He needs to get some harvesters up there as well. He needs to do something and do it quickly. Only one harvester. Does he have a war factory? He doesn't actually have a war factory right now. Ah, there we go. The APCs finally took out those power plants. Mass sell-offs there. Mass sell-offs of things that he didn't need. He needs a war factory. Ideally, that's probably what he's building now. This tip chem plant hasn't been used. He needs to use it to snipe something. Where is this? Okay, he's gone two ref on a dry field. What? That is a serious miscalculation. He needed ref here, not over there. I don't know quite what he thought he was doing there. But now he's moving back there. He's completely neglecting this field. Oh, no, there we go. We've got one harvester up there. Needs at least two more. Still got Predator tanks surviving somehow. The Cabals are coming in, but, you know, they're trying to flame down harvesters, which is going to be even less effective than the flame tank was. APC caught out here, but it's just Cabals, so they're not going to get a huge amount done. Now they're pushing in. There's his purifiers. He does tech, still has his tech. He has two refineries down in this field now. Has he sold off his tip chem plant? He has. Sadly, it didn't really get much done, did it? What is this? What is that harvester doing? The answer is nothing. The harvester is doing nothing. Is this refinery going to fall? Oh my god. Refinery fell to the Black Hand squad. That's careless. That's careless. Eon could have run those over very easily. Now he's left with no refinery there. He's going to have the long distance mine. There's another Black Hand squad coming around here. That's going to fall as well. One, two, three, four. What are these? These harvesters need to work out what they're doing. The APC is now retreating. They know they can't get in there, can they? He needs a solution to this. He needs APC pred, ideally. Teching up at this stage of the game is probably a bad idea, and to be honest, he doesn't need railguns to deal with two purifiers. I wonder if he's aware that there's no war factory. Once he downs those two purifiers, that's it. If he goes pred APC, he'll have enough to deal with most things. What is this? Black Hand squad is now bopping around here. He may as well sell those off because they're guarding absolutely nothing now. Riflemen out on patrol for no particular reason. Small force of APCs pushing in, but the purifiers are here. The Obelisk of Light is there. They're just going to die. They might kill a harvester if he's paying attention. He is. One harvester goes down. That's not bad. But then a purifier just sits here, and there's another APC. Now he has a war factory, and he's got a harvester to replace it. So you could argue that was worth it, but I would strongly disagree there. Looks like the flame units were taken out there. Bit of a sell-off of stuff there. We've still got his watchtowers up here, but they're serving no purpose at all. These riflemen and rocket troops are accomplishing nothing, but it's a very fragmented game now. Neither side, Redeemer, really? Okay. Selling off his war factory so he can produce a Redeemer. In fairness, a Redeemer is what he needs. And Orcus. Alright. If he was going to go air, Hammerheads would be the way to go. Not Orcus. He's going to try and go for the Harvester Snipes. Does he have his tier 2? Uh-oh, does he have his tier 2? He doesn't. I take it back. He'll be able to kill a couple of Harvesters here. And that is all he has right now. These Harvesters are now... Orcus are now going to get their presence betrayed. No, don't go that way, you pillock. Don't go that way. Kill the Harvesters. Kill them. One Harvester dies. Second Harvester will fall. Third Harvester should fall. He needs to commit to that. That's it. Good work. And are all the Orcas going to escape? Amazingly, all the Orcas escape. Three Harvesters down. But he's got just enough to get his Redeemer out.
The Redeemer.
Lovely work by Tivis there. He probably shouldn't have sold that off because he needed a Harvester, frankly. He needs a Harvester. Is he going to try and build a war factory? He probably has enough for a war factory, but he should have sold his tech, kept his Redeemer engineering facility, produced a couple of Harvesters off that. That's what he needed, ideally. And we've got a Marv coming out here. Orcas are dormant. They're not doing anything. They need to get in. They could take out one of these purifiers, or at least severely wear it down. Get the Orcs into action, dude. There we go. See, people do listen to me. I'm wise in the ways of Cain's Wrath. And now they're going to focus if he's paying attention. He's kind of paying attention. Keep firing, keep firing. Come on, you can do it. You can kill it. Kill it. One purifier falls. Good. That's worth the cost of an Orca. Marv is out. That Predator's completely out of position. Rage Chain goes off. Hopefully the Juggernaut will survive. Luckily, they're targeting down Harvester instead. They're going to be fine. And yep, the Purifier's not going to make it out of there. The Redeemer will. The Juggernaut needs to push forward and commit. This Redeemer is going to get out there, but they can kill this Purifier if they get in there. Quite sure what that was. That was a grenade throw that accomplished nothing by the looks of it. That purifier runs, Redeemer runs. But, oh dear, that is completely unsupported. He needs support. He needs Juggernauts. Where are the Orcas? Are they out and about over here? They should be out and about over here. There they are. There's Harvesters to kill. He can get those two killed quite easily. Where are you going? Where are you going? Kill. Kill them. Is he going to have enough to take this Harvester down, though? Nice. That's the Harvester down. The three Orcas escape, and now Tivis is absolutely starved for cash. He must be going for a refinery. He's selling everything he can afford. He can. But what is the Marv doing? What is the Marv doing? I mean, I get you, maybe you're confident, but you don't show your ass to a Redeemer. That's just ridiculous. Well, we have a Marv, we have a recaptured Purifier, that's smart. Did well there, two Juggernauts. Might well be enough to hold. He probably needs some APCs, really. Oh, there's Hammerheads out. I take it back. Purifier is going to fall. Nice work by the Orcas, that will be captured in due course. He does have Hammerheads out now. I missed that. They were focusing down on the Redeemer already, so the Rage Gen didn't get much done. And yep, Tibbs is thrown in a towel. There we go. Well, what can you say about that game, ladies and gentlemen? Or who am I kidding? Gentlemen. Nice little 24-minute game. And it was very back and forth, as promised. Tibbs had the advantage for a lot of it, let's be fair. Aeon made a few questionable choices. If he'd ecoed properly, he would have run away with that game completely. The Orcas were a good choice. I criticized them initially, but they got a lot of work done for him. It was smart that he went back to Hammerheads when he did. That, well, what can you say, maybe a few more flame tanks around the back from Tibbs could have crippled his eco once and for all. And Tibbs didn't take worse engagements than he needed to a lot of the time. Let's take a look at the units graph. Oh yeah, you can see where the engagements went a bit wrong for him, can't you? Whereas Eons were a little bit more consistent. APCs, Militant Rocket Squads, no surprises there. That kill-death ratio, though. That is really bad. You can tell Tibbs threw a lot of his units away when he didn't need to. And in the end, that's essentially what cost him the game. Well, I hope you all enjoyed the game. The replay is up on Game Replays if you want to go love it or whatever, if you think it's worth it. If you liked the video, feel free to like, of course, on YouTube. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I stream fairly regularly now on twitch.tv/LordBuzzKillington. Recently reached 50 followers, so feel free to follow me there. Subscribe to my channel if you like, or just cheer a couple of bits, because why the hell not? If you have replays you'd like me to cast, let me know through Twitch, through Game Replays, through Command Post, through Twitter, or just by yelling at me, I guess. And all that said and done, I have places to go and people to see, so I'll catch you all another time.